Over the last decade, under the leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi, India has achieved path-breaking achievements in the field of space science technology. ISRO has accomplished a stellar journey in space exploration over the years with successful missions like Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan, AstroSat, Aditya L1 and ExpoSat. These missions have garnered international recognition for the Indian space community. On July 14, 2023, the LVM3 M4 successfully launched the much-anticipated lunar mission Chandrayaan-3. After an incredible journey spanning around 4 lakh kilometers over the course of 40 days, the Chandrayaan-3 reached its destination, the Moon. On August 23, 2023, the Chandrayaan-3 spacecraft achieved a spectacular soft landing near the southern polar region of the Moon. After a few hours, rover ramped down from the lander and India embarked on a historic moonwalk. The Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, applauded the valiant efforts of ISRO scientists. He also saluted the pivotal contribution made by the women scientists of ISRO, the Nari Shakti, in the successful accomplishment of India's lunar landing mission.
23 अगस्त को जब भारत ने चंद्रमा पर तिरंगा फहराया, उस दिन को अब हिंदुस्तान नेशनल स्पेस डे के रूप में मनाया जाएगा.
To celebrate the inaugural National Space Day 2024, the entire country was categorized into 7 zones with various centers of ISRO and other ministries, academia, industries and institutions, the month-long conferences, talks, exhibitions, open houses, quiz, Bharatiya Antariksh Hackathon and ISRO Robotics Challenge, etc., were conducted as part of the National Space Day 2024. The theme selected for this year is Touching Lives While Touching the Moon, India's Space Saga. India's remarkable advancements in the space sector over the past decade demonstrates its unwavering commitment to scientific excellence, technological innovation and touching the lives of billions of people in the country. With an ambitious vision, the future of the Indian space program looks promising. This will inspire the next generation of scientists, engineers and explorers to reach beyond the universe.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we move forward to the much-awaited award ceremony. Awards will be presented to the winners of 2 competitions. Pehla competition hai robotics challenge ka. Hamare desh ke yuvaon mein space robotics ke prati ruchi jagane aur unki rachnatmak soch ko raftaar dene ke liye hi ISRO ne robotic challenge competition ka aayojan kiya, jisme ek aise rover ko design karna tha jo kai kaam kar sake. A rover that can identify sample, pick and drop at a location by autonomously navigating in a simulated lunar terrain. Proposals were received from 273 teams, out of which 10 teams qualified for the on-field competition. And finally, 3 winners are selected, whose space robotics are also displayed here in the exhibition. Dusra competition tha Bharatiya Antariksh Hackathon ka, jiska ayojan 4 July ko kiya gaya tha. और इस कार्यक्रम का मुख्य उद्देश्य था अंतरिक्ष आधारित अनुप्रयोगों में नवाचार के लिए एक मंच तैयार करना, जो उद्यमियों के लिए संभावित बिजनेस मॉडल में विकसित हो सके. देश भर के छात्रों को 12 क्षेत्रों से जुड़ी हुई समस्याएं दी गई थी, जिनका हल उन्हें तलाशना था. और अब मैं माननीय राष्ट्रपति महोदया से अत्यंत आदर भाव से करबद्ध निवेदन करती हूँ कि कृपया पुरस्कार प्रदान करने के लिए मंच पर आगे आए. लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वी बिगिन विद द विनर्स ऑफ रोबोटिक्स चैलेंज. थर्ड प्राइज गोज टू टीम समर्थ. मंच पर पधार रहे हैं टीम के सदस्य कार्तिक पांडे. फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स डेवलप्ड अ रोवर विद अ स्प्लिट व्हील कॉन्फ़िगरेशन टू एनहांस ऑब्स्टेकल क्लाइंबिंग, शोकेसिंग एक्सेप्शनल क्रिएटिविटी. नाउ इनवाइट मुस्कान, द सेकंड टीम मेंबर, टू रिसीव द अवार्ड. Second prize goes to team at Astra. I invite on dais Dhanush Kumar V. This team designed a rover that accomplished sample picking and dropping without the need of a robotic arm. Truly remarkable. And now Prabhakaran GS from the team receiving the award. And the winner of the first prize of the Robotics Challenges, team Titans. And right on dais and Jyot Kavle, and the team created a rover with safe sample handling and precise autonomous picking and dropping. Outstanding innovation skills indeed. And now Dipanshu Pise from the team is on the dais to receive the award. And now we have the winners of Bharatiya Antariksh Hackathon. Third prize goes to team Khagola. I invite Biggy Ram on the dais. This team developed an application which gave a new insight into the timing capabilities of our first multi-wavelength satellite, Astrosat. And now I invite Shyam Prakash VP to receive the award, the second member of the team Khagola. Second prize goes to team Lucene. First I invite Sambit Malik. The team developed Shakti, a shadow-based hybrid algorithm for knowledge of topological irregularities to detect craters and boulders using OHRC images. And now, Snigdha Paul receiving the award. And the winners of first prize of Bharatiya Antariksh Hackathon are team 10011. I invite Nadeep Singh Sidhu on the dais. This team developed Lunar, an application developed to predict safe navigation routes with 10 points of interest for rovers on the moon based on the given coordinates of the landing site. Riya Sachdeva is now receiving the award. Aapka bahut-bahut abhaar, Mananiya Rashtrapati ji, puraskar pradan karne ke liye. Ladies and gentlemen, ISRO, along with Indian Space Fraternity, is gearing up to realize the vision led by our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi. Nirantar, akankshi lakshyon ki or agrasar hai ISRO. Phir chahe baad 2035 tak Bharatiya Antariksh Station sthapit karne ki ho, ya phir 2040 tak kisi Bharatiya ki moon landing ki. Now we present before you a short film on Space Vision 2047.
Today, our satellites circling the Earth in space have literally touched the lives of millions of Indians. By simultaneously relaying thousands of telephone calls, enabling high-speed internet and hundreds of TV channels across the length and breadth of the country, they have brought in national integration as never before. And by enabling the provision of accurate weather forecasts and facilitating safe and accurate navigation, they now have a profound influence on the daily lives of Indians. The fact that the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, has also developed many launch vehicles to place these satellites in various orbits further underscores status of India as a major spacefaring nation. To strengthen the space ecosystem, the Government of India has incepted ENSIL to commercialize space technologies and InSpace to promote, regulate and monitor activities in the space sector. Together with ISRO, they unveil the Decadal Vision, setting the stage for India to emerge as a dominant global space power. The recent successful launches of Skyroot Aerospace's Vikram S rocket and Agnikul's Agniban are making waves. This is a game changer for the country's private space industry, ushering in new opportunities for entrepreneurs and scientists.
Now, as far as space economy is concerned, I think in the last 3 or 4 years, there's been a quantum jump. And I have the confidence to say that in the years to come, space economy would be an important component of India's overall economic growth.
As the latest chapter in its six-decade-old space saga, the country has now embarked on Gaganyaan, the maiden step in its ambitious human spaceflight program. A careful look at the history, and particularly from the past 10 years of Indian space program, makes us confident about India's future space vision 2047. The government of India, under the visionary leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, has laid down clear roadmap for the India's space exploration endeavors. ISRO is planning to develop India's next generation launch vehicle. Surya is a heavy lift rocket being developed by ISRO to carry payloads of up to 10 tons to geostationary transfer orbit GTO and 30 tons to low Earth orbit LEO. India's space station mission, Bharatiya Antariksh Station, aims to establish a sustainable Indian presence in space. The mission involves launching a modular and robotically built space station weighing around 52 tons into a low Earth orbit of 400 kilometers. The space station will serve as a research platform for scientists to conduct experiments in microgravity, astronomy, and Earth observation. India will witness launch of the first module of Bharatiya Antariksh Station by 2028. As a follow-up to Chandrayaan missions, India is gearing up to bring back samples from the moon through the Chandrayaan 4 mission. This mission is scheduled for 2027 and will feature demonstration of new technologies such as lunar docking, precise landing, sample collection and safe journey back to Earth.
2035 तक अंतरिक्ष में भारत का अपना स्पेस स्टेशन होगा जो हमें स्पेस के अज्ञात विस्तार को जानने में मदद करेगा. इतना ही नहीं, इसी अमृतकाल में भारत का एस्ट्रोनॉट भारत के अपने रॉकेट से चंद्रमा पर भी उतरकर दिखाएगा. 2047 तक भारत को विकसित राष्ट्र बनाने का संकल्प लिया है.
With these milestone missions, India will progress towards conducting sustained travel of Indian Gaganyatris to space, culminating in the Indian landing on the moon by 2040.
देवी और सज्जनों, राष्ट्रीय अंतरिक्ष दिवस मनाने का एक अहम उद्देश्य है विज्ञान और वैज्ञानिक सोच को आम आदमी तक पहुंचाना, ताकि वे इसे जानें और इसे लाभ भी उठा सकें, युवा वैज्ञानिक सोच विकसित कर सके. सो नाउ आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह टू एड्रेस द ऑगस्ट गैदरिंग ऑन नेशनल स्पेस डे.
भारत की राष्ट्रपति महामहिम श्रीपति द्रौपदी मुर्मू जी, अंतरिक्ष विभाग के सचिव एवं इसरो के चेयरमैन श्रीमान एस सोमनाथ जी, इस सभागृह में उपस्थित विज्ञान के भिन्न भिन्न क्षेत्रों से पधारे हुए विशेषज्ञ गण, महानुभाव, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आज का दिन बड़ा ही शुभ दिन है, शुभ अवसर है और हम सब भाग्यशाली हैं. भाग्यशाली इसलिए कि भारत का सर्वप्रथम राष्ट्रीय अंतरिक्ष दिवस अथवा नेशनल स्पेस डे का उत्सव मनाने का काम हमारे हिस्से में आया है। आज से ठीक एक वर्ष पूर्व 23 अगस्त 2023 को हमारे एक स्पेस मिशन चंद्रयान ने इतिहास रच करके दुनिया को चकाचौंध कर दिया। चंद्रमा के साउथ पोल पर पहुंचने वाला वो पहला स्पेस मिशन था और तभी प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने ये घोषणा की कि प्रतिवर्ष इस दिन को राष्ट्रीय अंतरिक्ष दिवस के रूप में मनाया जाएगा, ताकि हम जहां एक ओर चंद्रयान की गुणगान को स्मरण कर सकें, वहीं साथ ही साथ आने वाले समय के लिए कार्यसूची एजेंडा पर चिंतन मंथन भी कर सकें। ये कोई साधारण बात ना थी, जैसे सोमनाथ जी ने कहा, जिस चांद के दीदार के लिए दुनिया इंतजार करती है, उस दिन भारत ने उसे छू करके महसूस किया था। And the world never expected that we would be able to achieve this feat because our journey in space was just about 55 years long. ISRO was born in the year 1969, the year which is remembered for the first human being having landed on the surface of moon, Neil Armstrong. And we were just getting born. And today, the same ISRO, the same team, within 50 years, just about half a century, we became the first to have landed on the South Pole of Moon before anybody else could do. And therefore, when we observe the National Space Day, it's also a day of introspection, reflection, and also to create roadmaps for the future, and also to ponder about how did we manage to cover this long journey in a short time, and where do we go from here. और यदि आप इन प्रश्नों का उत्तर ढूंढें तो ध्यान में आएगा कि हमारे वैज्ञानिकों के पास, हमारे विशेषज्ञों के पास प्रतिभा की कमी ना थी, योग्यता की कमी ना थी, मेहनत करने का मादा भी था, आंखों में अरमान भी थे।